Disperse into the abyss of nihility! Gushing water! Aquarius sphere! Raging wind! Prism stars! I humble myself in the void! Shining gate! Primal fire! Nova explosion! Urban darkness! Maxwell mirror! Perish! Dimensional material!
I won't move! We will carry on our dreams! Lower!
This cannot be.
Hello, this is Master in 347, the exciting playthrough of Banjo Kazooie. And last time we got the ability we got from this world right here. But yep, basically going on this path right here, be careful not to fall, since in death, into the lava, and go through this way. We activated the door last time, but didn't really show you where to actually go. But yep, here it is. Mad Monster Mansion. So let's go. Like I said, there are no more new moves we can learn because, well, we've learned them all. But there is a new transformation we can do here, which I'm actually going to save till last because we actually need it. Yeah, maybe. But yeah, this place holds a lot of nooks and crannies, so you gotta look everywhere. Alright. Alright. Oh, there's an first ginger. If I did. Ow! Oh, that's poison? Got ya. Now be careful of the jumping on top of here. What the? I thought I could break these. Oh, it's from the other side. Yeah, make sure you smash those down. Yeah, be careful in jumping on top of here. These are for the fawns, so you don't want that. Maybe jump up here. Oh, dang it. Oh, come on. There we go. Let's quickly transform because we can slip down here. Shoot. But break this? And we have to get to our first jiggy. These two guests are rather dumb. Let's make sure they're unwelcome. Okay, this will be the game. You basically need to spell out your name as quickly as possible. That's an N, isn't it? Yeah, that's right. Make sure not to get confused. I'm getting these first, just to good measure. Let's see, where are the rest of these letters at? There we go, there's a Z. It's best to look around first, try to memorize where the letters are, so you don't get confused. That's a Z, yes. And that's an N. I'm trying to make sure I don't get those two mixed up. By the way, you jump on here. Greetings, old solid one. I'm Tumblr, the mighty solve. Solve the puzzle, and you can take this infernal thing that's stuck under me. There you go, so that works. So you move like this. Careful, don't touch any of the Gruntilda blocks. And you gotta do it in time. It's sort of similar to the sandcastle one. JJ. KKK, where are you? There we go. B Gates. K A. There it is. Ah! Come on! There we go. Doing well so far. Yeah, that guy's the worst. There's the extra O. Then it's just an I and E and we are done. And make sure that guy moves first. Oh, it's gonna be close. Got it! At last! The puzzle is solved! Take this thing. I'm leaving this gloomy shed. Yeah, I know it's a ghost. Yeah, not too bad. Now I recommend you look around the place first to try and memorize where the letters are so you can have a better time. Be careful the ghost over hits you, it takes quite a bit of damage. But luckily, with all of the extra health we've gotten, we are more than prepared. Grab that one first. I think the only way to kill the ghosts here, or the enemies, is to use you know, the invincibility feathers. Make sure you smash open these gates. We need to go here later on in a hurry. But we can actually get something here. What we have to do is
thank you.
Feed all these pots something. And be careful, some of these graves are fake.
Thank you.
Alright. Back off. Pretty simple enough. We can aim properly. Huh?
Thank you.
That's odd. I guess it didn't relish there. Boo! Get out of it. Let's get it. This.
Thank you.
Pretty simple, really. And with that, we end of a jiggy. Simple. Is that another game needs breaking down? There we go. Make sure you break these gates for later on. Okay, now we're actually going to go inside this mansion. But there's a time limit. Let's see. Where is it? There should be a switch around here. Let's see, is it around here maybe? Ah, so it is. Here it is. Okay, let me just try out my path first. Go, 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 go! Ah, and... Dang it. Here the door is very tough. Stupid bear is not fast enough. We'll get there. Alright. Let's go up here first then. Ugh. There'd be something up there as well. Fine, I'll do it later. Folks, let's not try and multitask too much here. Let's try this again. So the time is very small. But now I actually know where I'm going, I should have a much better chance. Go, go, go. Made it. We can get a few jiggies here. No, actually, I think it's only one jiggy. But we get a few other things we can get around here as well. Stupid ghosts. Okay, that's it. Go away. That's the only way to get rid of those guys. You can't really attack them normally. You have to use your golden feathers. It's annoying, but this is how it is. Right, let's get these notes. It's going to be annoying us for a while. But this next mini game you have to do, I think it's like a memory based game. Not too tough. Oh! Wrong button. Nah. Thought I can make that jump. Alright, let's have a look around first. Anything behind here? Nope, just a bunch of honey canes with beads on them. Time that just in time that one light. Oh, come on! Mozart plays his organ V's, but can you follow him on the keys? Just as soon as it hits a key, you ground pound it. That's all you have to do, including the black keys as well. Oh. Yeah, you don't have to memorize it or anything. Just follow him. Not bad, Bear. But now watch me copy this. And copy this to an amazed RB. It's a bit faster this time. No, anyway. Just make sure, be a bit careful not to actually hit the white key when you're trying to hit the black one. Better just to stand right in front of it like so. So that you can accurately ground pound it. But yeah, not too tough. It's just literally just follow the leader sort of thing. It's not actually have to memorize exactly what it all is. You probably could do that if you wanted to, but why do that? Make it harder for yourself. Nope. Your music skills are nicely fine, so take this golden piece of mine. See? Not tough in the slightest. Pretty simple, really. There! Stupid skeleton thing. There's another life there, if you want it. Nice. Okay, there's one more thing we can do around here. There it is! Yeah, the fly pad. I was looking for that. And what I have to do is fly all the way up here. Not only for that honey cone, and for another Jimbo token, I mean Mumbo token, but there's also the Gruntilda block. It's around here too. There we go. Be a bit careful here. See, the Gruntilda block is right there, as you can see. There we go. We get that pretty much at the end. Yeah, but now we're gonna try and get down there. Is there another fly pad, or do we have to wing it, so to speak? There was probably a better way to do that. There's a man. That's all we have to do around here. Wait, is there a ginger around here? No, I well remembered. But yeah, it automatically closes afterwards, so, you know, just make sure that the... get it there. There we go. That was it. Yeah, it's quite slippery, so be careful. Nope. Okay. Just being careful. There we are. Bingo! There! That's everything up around there. Ooh. Okay, let's see what we got down here. Yeah, there's a lot of breakable things in this level. Get out of it. Let's see, break one of these. One of these should have a jiggy. One should have one of those. There we go. And then one, there should be a ginger on here. And the musical notes appear. Wait, is the one I forgot to break open? Nope, I broke them all. Alright. Let's take them, let's check them, guys. Okay, so that takes care of that. Go away. Okay, and next are these. Yeah, see these glowing lights here? You can break them. Walk under these floorboards. Oh yeah, oh yeah, I can't get that one yet. Not until I transform. Oh well, I've broken the window anyway. So we can get the one later. Just make sure you always break all the windows and stuff. You can tell which ones you can break because they're the ones that are flashing light. Unfortunately, we can't get that one either. Not until, again, not until we transform, which I'm saving for last. But make sure you at least break all those, dang it. Make sure you at least break all of the windows there. It says in the transformation I have can't really attack at all. Oh. You're right. There he is. Up there. Shoot. Nope, nothing else on here. I'll just be careful of the edges. Easy, does it? There we go. And as you saw, there's another glass we can smash here. So, let's smash it. Oh, dang it. Alright, let's see what's through this one. Yeah, not falling for that. think that's it really. It's just these pieces here. Okay, jump. Okay, lastly. Yeah. Now we could sneak through the front door if we wanted to by breaking those windows, but that would have woke him up. And in doing so... Dang it! Ah, oh, man. Yeah, I did it wrong. You're supposed to jump on the chairs without him realizing you're there. Good news is, though, we can break through here. Dang it, I did it wrong. I did it wrong again. This is why I do playthroughs, folks. Not walkthroughs. That's stressful that way. The walkthrough, you have to have it. See, the thing about a walkthrough and the playthrough is a playthrough, I can play however I want. There's never any mistakes, so I can just do my own thing. A walkthrough, people are following you exactly and want to try and do exactly what you do all the time. So, that's the definition of a walkthrough. Able to emulate what you do or make something much easier that anyone can basically do it. Yeah, I remember now. Jump on the chairs. I'm going to use gold. How it shone. Should be mad. Now it's gone. Yes, I'm mad. My boot, I put up your useless spooky butt. There we go, he's gonna sneak. Let's get these musical notes. There's something else around here? Is we have a fly pad? Maybe another Mumbo token or something? Let's find out, shall we? Wait, that's it? An extra life? Whatever. Okay, there's still a few things we can get around here. Let's have a look. Never been that way. This way's gonna be a little confusing. Let's see, I think one of them was like a maze, wasn't it? Oh, wait, I remember this one. Oh yeah, I gotta dive down here. Ow. Oh, I remember now. Oh yeah, there's a quicker way. Oh yeah, I'm gonna get this one later when I transform. Oh yeah, I remember now. Just let's get back up this way. I'm gonna make sure I get the rest of these. Awkward. go. Getting those. Is that it now? Do the rest I can get simply through the transformation? Nope, just eggs. But yeah, smash all the windows. Gotta make sure. Nope. I think there's another window on the other side. Here we are. Really? That was it for this side? It was just feathers? Ugh. Wasting my time like that. Okay then. Oh yeah, the maze. I guess I can do this. Go away. Alright, let's go get these musical notes at least. Is there anything else I need to break as Banjo before I transform? To make sure. Nope, it looks like we're safe for the time being. Remember, don't walk on those thorny parts right there. You take damage from. Ow! Dang it! I take my own advice. Okay, let's go find a Mumbo. Oh yeah! This is actually a secret. This is for extra lives or this is for an extra life or any extra any feathers he needs, so yeah, I forgot to show you guys that. Pretty cool thing to put there. Here it is. Anything else up here? Okay then. We need about 20 Mumbo tokens, but we have enough. Pumpkin. Ah, Mumbo Prowler Pumpkin Spell. Make good soup. With a pumpkin, we can fit into tight spaces we couldn't do before. Oh, so you're probably wondering again, how do we get to the top of those stairs then, aka like the roof area? Well, let's see, there should be, we go through the maze, remember we saw that small, staircase, sort of ledge, with a little hill. The thing is though, is that the pumpkin can not only fit into small spaces, but can also, you can walk on top of these forms without taking any type of damage, so that's quite useful. Let's see. Where is it? Dang it. It's around here somewhere. Oh, it doesn't matter. I can do that in a bit. First of all, let's go get that remaining Mumbo which we couldn't get, particularly that remaining Jigs which we couldn't get before. Yeah, I'm pretty sure with this I can be much easier. There we go. See? Much easier. Let's be a bit careful around here. And if we jump through here, but it's not about breathing underwater and stuff. That's the other thing as well. Oh yeah, and you can survive this little swamp area as well, I suppose. Little hill. And I'm back. Sorry about this, but I found it. It's right around here. Yeah. This tiny little corner right here. That's what I was having the problem with. Man. But anyway. First of all, let's check out, let's see, which window is which. There we go, we're down here first. We get our second honeycomb piece, so that's nice. If you jump down here, happy landing, little one. Need to this little sewer part right here. Which is all the way to a jiggy. Thank you. can't believe you went in there. Now wash your hands, filthy bear. So that's one. And the other one is... let's see, one of these holes down here. These two little, sort of like mini hut. There it is. Just need to go down this one hole right here. There we go. And that's three of these musical notes are here. Look, we found all the notes from this world. Well done. Yeah, sorry about the pause there, guys. Yeah. Like I said, I don't remember every little thing about this game, so, you know, I'm only human. But when you exit the world, exit as the pumpkin. This much I do remember. Oh, come on. Let's see. Go through here. Oh, son of a bitch! I forgot to break down the door! Oh my god, I'm so stupid! Alright, just one thing after another day. Alright. I'll be back once I break down this door. Look like I can untransform easy by running out of the area. I kind of forgot to do that. See you guys then. Oh, I'm so fucking stupid. Alright. No point editing this out that much because we're going to tell you right here. Remember? Oh my, I broke down the gate now, so it's broken now. But yeah, basically make sure you break the gate first before you even enter the level. That's the mistake I made. I can't believe I forgot to do that. And you can't fit through this little hole because, well, Banjo Kazooie will be too small. So you need to enter through here as the pumpkin. Then you need to transform back. Do this. You saw Banjo, but changed tack. Imagine you on Gwendy's back. Anyway, let's end this. And it's just to help back to make the next world. So yeah, make sure you do that. Pretty sure you can't break down this door. Yeah, you need to transform back into the pumpkin. So yeah, you gotta do that to help out. But that's that, 100%ed. Pumpkin making Mumbo hungry. Get me pot ready. There we go. I wonder where Gruntilda is. Remember she was supposed to be around here somewhere. She's probably behind one of these gravestones. I think it's so annoying to fight. Well, I can't fight back as the pumpkin. I guess I was thinking of something else. There's another place you can go with the pumpkin as well, that little hole, but I think that's for the post game, so I'm not gonna go through there. Let's go through here again, and then the magic will wear out, and you can return back to normal. And the magic get weak. Oh, magic went out. There we go. Make sure to hit that platform there. is to help you access the next world. But before that, let's get that other jiggy. The one that we activated with that Quintilda block. There it is. It's just like we did when how we got the other one. We need to activate that flying platform. So again, we have to run and see if we can get there in time. Okay, so just like before. Okay, gotta hurry. Go, 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 go. Made it. Alright, now we need to make it through that little glass and smash it a bit. There. Made it. Dang it. So before we end this, I have to better show you where the next world is, and oh man, if you thought that world was annoying, that was me being making mistakes because of this heat. I am boiling hot today. But this next world is, there's no excuse, this world is just horrible. It's the worst in the game. Very, very tough. The difficulty is just nuts. Really goes up for this next one. But as you can see, the water is up a bit now. So here, I watch you play. But I can't think of much to say. So, go up here. However though, the well is still not open yet, so we're going to have to raise the water a bit more. I'm going to fall for these, for those guys again. So... Huh, that rare cinder block looks suspicious. Let's break it. To reveal this. And it buries up the water even more. And it's access that little tunnel over there. I'm only doing this because it's quicker than the swimming on the surface. Alright then. Now this one's a bit well hidden, but break this. And here we go. We've activated the next level. Rusty Bucket Bay. Oh, I am loving this next level. But yeah. If you thought that level was tough, it is nothing compared to Rusty Bucket Bay. Said to be probably the toughest level in the entire game. And for good reason. For good reason indeed. So yeah, sorry about all the screw-ups I did back there. Like I said, I'm not perfect, I make mistakes. But anyway, I edited out all the wandering around too much, so you know. So it makes more sense to you guys. Oh, Rusty Bucket Bay, this level is, oh man, that level is just, oh, it's hell. But, that's where we're going next time. We're almost done with this game, guys. We've still got at least one other world after that, but, you know, we're getting there. But with that, it's Master Room 347, Game Thought Times Origin of the Platformer. Stay classy.